wrapping up our series on the fruit of the Spirit with the last of the 9 virtues, and that is self-control. Why do you think that virtue is listed last? God knows our tendency towards checklists. He knows our tendency towards rules and becoming religious. The very first of the 9 is love. And then it goes through the list. And I think it's very important for us to study each one of those and really grow in our understanding and how those are operating in our lives before we ever get to this last one, self-control. Because often we can make our entire spiritual experience about our behavior, our list of to-dos and our list of to-don'ts, the things that we're supposed to do and the things that we're not supposed to do. And then we start spreading those things. We come up with our list and we show them to someone else and say, if you want to have a relationship with God, this is what you do. Boom, 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 boom. But as we've talked about the fruit of the Spirit, this idea of self-control only comes through a relationship with Jesus. Jesus teaches us that He is the vine and that we are the branches coming off of that vine. If we abide in Him, then we will produce much fruit. That's what Jesus said. It's in red words. It's in quotes. He said, if you abide in Me, you will produce much fruit. Now, when He's talking about the fruit, and we're talking about the fruit of the Spirit is the fruit of the Holy Spirit in us. The Holy Spirit lives in us because we have a relationship with Him. As we grow in our intimacy with Him, as we grow in our relationship with Him, then automatically this fruit will be produced. So then when we get to this last word of self-control, if it's not just about controlling our behavior, but actually allowing the Holy Spirit to be involved in helping us to control our behavior, then it changes things, doesn't it? When we look at the Greek word, it actually means dominion within. So I like to just completely take away the self-control word just because of all the ideas that we already have wrapped around it and replace it with dominion within. Because when we talk about dominion, we're talking about a kingdom, a king's domain. Self-control, dominion within, is bringing the kingdom of God into us, building the kingdom of God right here. It's not about out there. It begins right here. And that's what this word self-control really means, dominion within. So how does that apply to your life? If you've invited Jesus Christ to live in your life, then the Holy Spirit is living in you, and He wants to bring the kingdom of God into you. What we like to do with religion is we say, if you control yourself, if you have your lists, if you do this, if you do these things, then you are saved. But Scripture teaches us that you are saved by faith, and then in your faith relationship with God, you will become like Him. And as you're becoming like Him, you will produce His kind of fruit. So it's not as much dependence on me and what I can do as dependence on God and leaning into Him and saying, God, what can You do with this? If we're acting in a religious manner, then it's like seeing an apple and saying, I want to be an apple, so I'm going to paint myself red. And you paint yourself red and then you say, bam, there I am, I'm an apple. It doesn't work like that. If you wanted to become an apple, you would have to do some extreme transformation, which would really require some supernatural, miraculous power, because in the natural, you cannot become an apple. And it's really the same thing. When we see Jesus, we want to be like Jesus. But in our own strength, it's just like painting ourselves a certain color. It doesn't change anything. It's by the miraculous power of the Holy Spirit operating in us, changing us, bringing the kingdom of God inside of us, that we begin to look like Him.